You know, Steve, I know that that's been part of the president's initiative in terms of some of the things that they've been looking at and suggesting. My thing is, as long as the young man performs the way he's supposed to perform academically, as long as he does what he's supposed to do in the community, not have any issues, you know, that would bring embarrassment to himself, the program, or the university, that the scholarship is renewed every year. I mean, I don't go yanking scholarships or anything like that. And as long as the young men are doing that, it's been my history everywhere I've been, in Richmond and here, the last couple of years, is to honor those scholarships. It's when you guarantee something and those young men fall outside of the boundary of doing what they're supposed to do in the community, doing what they're supposed to do academically. You know, if you have policies about class attendance and performance in the class, you know, things like that, if they continue to show that they have a disregard for that, then there has to be some way that you have remedy to say, you know what, I'm not going to continue this and reward that type of behavior. And maybe those schools that said four-year scholarships might have kind of an addendum as long as you do what I just talked about. Maybe that's part of what they have. But right now, you know, ours is a one-year renewable, understanding that it's a two-way street. I got to coach you and teach you, give you the examples of what's expected, and then you have to do what's expected in order for every July when you renew those scholarships to make it happen again.
You said you were nervous until you got all the scholarships in hand. But relatively speaking, is this about as stress-free a National Signing Day as you've had?
Seriously, Doug, it's never stress-free. I watched some of the basketball game last night, left, picked up my son, long out of five guys, stayed up, you know, watching Jay Leno do his opening monologue. Saw some old Sally Jesse Raphael, you know, stuff, and just, you know, just because you're always worried about the things that you can't control. And that's what happens a lot of times with all of us. We worry about things we can't control instead of just relatively speaking, with guys that have said that they're coming, we just had our official visit weekend, you know, not last week, but the week before, and it was a love fest then, so you felt pretty good. But at the same time, you know, like I said, somebody brought up the example of what happened today, 30 minutes before, you know, whatever happened when the young man decommitted. And you're always worried about, did somebody get to your young man before then? You know, was anything ethical or unethical done? Those are things that you can't control, that sometimes, you know, people may change their minds. But I always worry. And now I'm not worried because they're all signed, you know. So, but until that happened, it's an anxiety and anticipation of what's to come, because I look at this class and who's in it, particularly with the defensive ends. I look at it as guys that could make a significant impact, you know, in this program because of that height and that athleticism. I look at the tall players that we brought up just a few minutes ago about athletes, not only offense, defense, but special teams that bring another element to go along with the Perry Joneses and the Kevin Parks, Dominic Terrell, and those guys like that. So, you know, we had some short guys, now we added some tall guys.
How many coaches in America do you think were watching that Sally Jesse Raphael?
Probably none.
Yeah, you don't bring that up in living room,
that's,
do you? Because that would
TV
be like
right there. Yeah,
when was that?
That's 399 channels that I have to flip through. So.
That's about 380 too many, Coach.
2 o'clock.
We're going to take a question from Jeff and Michael, and then we've got a coach.